Kate?
7.
And Gerald?
I'm going to try a risky 7.
OK, what's your risky 7 then, Gerald?
Parolee, somebody who's on parole.
Mm-hmm. Parolee, yeah.
OK.
And Kate, yours?
Enabler.
Enabler.
Well, check that one as well. A parolee is absolutely fine, no problem with that, Gerald, at all. And can you be an enabler if you facilitate something? You can, yes, they're both fine.
OK,
well,
very good. What have you got over there for us?
Well, something I can never be accused of, beanpole. Mm. And operable we've got as well, both yes. 8.
There's a footballer called Gregor Rajak, and he's 6'5", and he's skinny as a rake, and he comes from Warsaw, so he's a beanpole, yeah. Quite clearly. Kate has 44, Gerald has 32 at the moment. Here's another letters collection. Kate, it's your pick.
All right, vowel, please.
Thank you. I.
And another.
Another I.
And another.
E.
Consonant.
T.
And another.
S.
And another.
V.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And a consonant.
N.
And a consonant, please.
And to finish, M.
Time starts now. Gerald, how many?
Risky 7.
And Kate?
7.
What's the risky 7 then, Gerald?
Unities.
Unities. OK. And Kate?
Minutes.
And minutes.
Yep, absolutely fine. Sure you can pluralise unity, and yes, you can, so no problem with that either.
OK. A couple of good words. Can you match it? Can you beat it over there?
Well, we've got 8. Mutinies.
I like that one. Thank you.
Very good. Mutinies would have been 8, but both Kate and Gerald pick up 7 for a couple of very decent words. It means that Kate has 51. Gerald's still very much in this. He has 39. They can both take a breather for a moment or two. It's the time of the programme where we cross to Susie, who's going to tell us about some origins of words. What have you got for us today, Susie?
I thought I'd do some sporting terms for the next few shows, and to talk about steeplechases. That a steeplechase today, obviously, is a race either across country or on a maid's course with lots of obstacles, water jumps, etc. But why the steeple? And the original one was, the original race was one that had a church steeple in view, and that was the end goal. So all the intervening obstacles that the country had to offer in a natural way had to be overcome, fences, ditches, ponds. And today, obviously, the church steeple is no longer the goal, but all the intervening obstacles still remains. And canter is also a nice one. Obviously, the horses do a bit more than that in the steeplechase. But the word canter began as a shortened form of Canterbury pace or Canterbury gallop, because mounted pilgrims who were making their way to Canterbury to visit the shrine of St. Thomas of Becket would go at a gentle, leisurely pace, a sort of canter. And that's where it comes from.
Very good. I've got a share in a horse, Susie, and trust me, he does nothing more than canter, even during a steeplechase. Yeah. Let's move on to our next round. It's a numbers round, and Gerald, it's your selection.
2, 1, 1, 2, please.
Thank you. So 2, 1, 1, and 2. So for this round, we have 2, 1, 9, 5, and the large 75 and 100, and the target 702.
And 30 seconds to get there. Kate?
701.
And Gerald?
I think I've got 702.
OK, well, let's hear it, Gerald.
75 minus 5.
75 minus 5 is 70.
Times 9 plus 1.
Times 9 plus 1 is 700.
And add the 2.
And add the 2. Lovely.
Very good indeed. Well done. It means it's a very close contest. Kate has 51. Gerald's closed right up. He has 49. Here's another teaser for you. The words this time are Opal Jean. Opal Jean. And the clue, spice up your life with a hot green Mexican. Spice up your life with a hot green Mexican. Spice up your life with a hot green Mexican. Jalapeno is the answer, of course. We have a hot, spicy contest at the moment. Kate has 51 and Gerald has 49. Kate's our defending champion. Here's our next letters round. And Kate, it's your pick.
Vowel, please.
Thank you. Start with E.
And another.
A.
And another.
I.
And consonant.
C.
And another.
M.
And another.
S.
And another.
Q.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, G.
30 seconds starts now. Gerald, what have you found?
Risky six.
OK. Kate?
Six.
Let's have the risky six first, then, Gerald.
Magics.
Magics, yeah. And Kate?
Same word.
Yeah, okey-doke.
OK.
Yes, that's absolutely fine. You might think it has the K in it, but it doesn't. That's very good indeed, as the verb. Okay.
Yeah. What have you conjured up over there for us?
Well, we had magics as well, and that's the hardest one we've done today. I think we had images as well, yeah. Which is six. Mm.
Yeah. Tricky little collection of letters, weren't they, but... both Kate and Gerald conjuring up magics and consequently 6 points apiece for them. On to our next letters round. Gerald, your pick this time.
Start with a consonant, please.
Thank you. D.
And another one.
S.
And another one.
N.
And a vowel, please.
U.
Another vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
H.
Another consonant.
C.
Another consonant. And
T.
a final vowel.
And a final E.
Time starts now. Kate, how many?
Nine.
Gerald?
Only seven.
Let's hear the seven first.
Haunted.
Haunted. Kate, you delivered that very nonchalantly.
Let's I'm hear not it. Sure. Staunched.
Staunched.
OK, as in to staunch a wound or something, possibly.
Yes.
I think might be fine. And it is, Kate. Well done. It is.
Yes, a fantastic word, staunched. Very well done, Kate. So, match that if you can.
Well, we couldn't at first. We had scathed, which was seven, and then Susie quickly realised we could put un in front of it. Unscathed, nine. Get in there, hey?
Great stuff. On to our next letters round. Kate, it's your pick this time.